Hi friends, welcome you all to this video. This is my 8th lecture of 2nd unit transmission system. Okay, in previous lecture I given introduction on clutch and necessity of clutch. So in this unit we are going to see about the coil spring clutch. Okay, so two types, one is coil spring and diaphragm. So we are going to, in this class we are going to see coil spring clutch or coil spring pressure plate. Okay, so as usual, this is a automobile engineering subject and the code is 162-5505. This is as per SPDE Bihar. Okay, and we are going to see coil spring pressure plate or coil spring clutch. It is 8th lecture and myself, I am Arun Pandian, lecturer in mechanical department of GEMS Polytechnic College, Aurangabad, Bihar. Okay, so the main content what we are going to see in this chapter, in this video, what are the content we are going to see inside of this video. Number one, pressure plates. What is pressure plates we are going to see. Number two, types of pressure plates. Number three, coil spring pressure plate. Number four, definition. Number five, working principle. Number six, advantages, disadvantages. Okay, so regarding these topics we are going to see inside of this video. So let us go, what is pressure plates? Okay, so now we are going to see the definition of pressure plates. Okay, the pressure plates provides the clamping force to clamp the clutch disc between the pressure plate and the flywheel so that torque can be transmitted between those parts. Okay, to clamp. Okay, that to a clamping force to the clamp the clutch disc and the pressure plate. Okay, so between the clutch disc and pressure plate, for the clamping force we are using the pressure plate. The force is generated by one or more very strong springs. When the driver pushes the clutch pedal, the spring or springs in the pressure plate are what the driver is pushing against. Okay, so against, so if I push down against that, it will press the spring like that. So pushing the clutch pedal compresses the springs and removes the clamping force from the clutch disc. So if I lift it, the clamping force will be there. If I push it, so how the clamping force will be released, it will be removed. Okay, number four, releasing the clutch pedal allows the springs to apply their clamping forces to the clutch disc again. Okay, if I release it again, it will apply the clamping forces. If I push the clutch pedal, it will compress and the clamping force will be removed. If I release the clutch pedal, the clamping force will be applied and the clutch disc with the clutch disc. Okay, the last one, most automotive pressure plates are of either the diaphragm spring style or the coil spring. Anyone it is having. Okay, the next one, we are going to see the types of pressure plate. There are two types of pressure plate. One is coil spring style, the second one is diaphragm spring style. Coil spring style and diaphragm spring style. But here we are going to see about coil spring style. Okay, in this video we are going to only see coil spring style. So definition. Okay, so the definition, so what is the definition of coil clutch spring? Coil clutch springs are compression springs which may be used in different types of clutches. Okay, so this coil clutch spring can be, if you say coil clutch springs are compression springs. Okay, it compresses the springs. Okay, in previous slide we have seen that the compression springs means if I push the pedal, the clamping force will be removed. If I release the pedal, the clamping force will be applied. That is the main thing. Okay, so same here, it is a compression springs. Some are used in clutch dampers to control vibrations and sound. So number two, number one, it is a compression springs. Second point, it is a clutch dampers which control the vibration and sound. The third point, the compression springs are compressed by the radial vibration of a drifting engine. Radial vibrations. Okay. So this is the three points which are define the definition of compression coil clutch spring or coil spring pressure plate. Okay. So again, I'm explaining you. Number one, first point is coil clutch springs are compression springs which may be used in different types of clutch. So number first point is compression spring. Coil clutch spring is a compression springs. Second point, some are used in clutch dampers to control vibrations and sound. So number two, it is used as a to control vibrations and sound. Number three, the compression springs are compressed by the vibration, radial vibrations. Okay, so the compression springs are compressed by the radial vibration. This is the third point. Okay, so this is these are the three points which defines the meaning of coil spring pressure plate or coil clutch springs. Got it? So this is the coil spring pressure plate. This is the figure of coil spring pressure plate. If you see here, this is the pressure plate, retaining cap screw, washer, back plate, adjusting screw and lock nut. Okay, this lock nut and adjusting screw, these two are used to I want to give more pressure or less pressure. So keep that on my mind. I can adjust the screw and also I can, after adjusting it, I have to lock by using the lock nut. Okay, and here washers are there, retaining cap screw are there, and pressure plate. This is the pressure plate which gives the pressure when you push or release the pedal. Okay, clutch pedal. This is the main pressure plate. This will be attached with the normal mechanism with the clutch pedal. Now working principle. Okay, so we are going to see the working principle of coil spring pressure plate or coil spring coil clutch spring. Okay, so now the first point is the coil spring pressure plate uses coil springs to create the clamping pressure and uses release levers to release the clutch disc. Okay, so coil springs uses a coil spring. In the name, there is the meaning. So if you see my previous classes, I have said that word in each and every class. Some word classes I have told. What is that? In mechanical is a big advantage, the meaning of the word, otherwise the name of any component will be defined by using its name itself. Okay, the meaning will be on the same word which we are, if it is written, define coil spring pressure plate. Okay, so the coil spring I am going to use in this pressure plate, that is why it is called as a coil spring. So what purpose we are using, that you must be in mind. So first of all, name, and second one, what purpose. Okay, for the clamping pressure. Okay, the clamping pressure, if I use the coil springs and I use the release levers to release the clutch disc. Okay, so this is the first working principle of coil spring pressure plate. Typically, three or four release levers are used depending on if the application is in a car or a truck. Okay, so depending upon that, they will have a three or four release levers. Okay, so to release that lever, the coil spring pressure plate may have three or four, depending upon the application is in car or a truck. Okay. So typically three or four levers will be there. Okay. The released levers control the movement of the friction portion of the pressure plate. Okay. The released lever control the movement. Okay. Where if the lever is released, it control the movement of the friction portion of the pressure plate. Okay. And the next one is, it is continuing. The first point is, they pivot on the pedestals that are part of the pressure plate housing. They means, as usual, coil spring pressure plate. Okay. They pivot on the pedestals that are part of the pressure plate housing. Okay. It is a pressure plate housing. Second, the fifth point is, when the release bearing pushes the levers toward the flywheel, they pivot and pull the friction portion of the pressure plate back toward the driver, which then relinquishes its clamping pressure on the clutch disc. Okay. When the release bearing pushes the levers toward the flywheel, if I am pushing the release bearing, okay, toward the flywheel, they pivot and pull the friction portion. It will pivot and the coil spring will pivot and pull the friction portion of the pressure plate back toward the driver, if I release it, okay? So, which then relinquishes its clamping pressure on the clutch disc, okay? And next, it is say that when the clutch pedal is released, okay? When the clutch pedal is released, the levers return to their rest position. The clamping force is restored to the clutch disc. Torque is transmitted and the vehicle moves forward. Okay. So, this is the working principle of coil spring pressure plate. Okay. And now, what are the advantages of coil spring? By using the coil spring pressure plate, what are the advantages? Number one is, the tighter the clamping force and torque capacity. The tighter, it will be a tighter. That is a big advantage for the clamping force and torque capacity. For the clamping force and torque capacity. Second point is, can be recycled non-throwaway item. Okay, it can be recycled non-throwaway item. And the disadvantages. What are the disadvantages? Number one, the springs can become weak and the clamping force is compromised. The springs can become weak. It can become weak and the clamping force is compromised. Once a clutch starts slipping, it likely will need to replace very soon. If the clutch starts to slip, okay, the coil spring pressure plate will not transmit or clamp with a full force, okay? So we have to replace very soon. That is a big disadvantage. It is very heavy, so that is also, it is very heavy in weight, so it is a big disadvantage. And the fourth point is, diaphragm spring is round, multi coil spring cause vibrations. It causes the vibrations, and coil spring pressure indicates when the clutch pedal is pressed, diaphragm spring remains constant. Okay, next we are going to see the diaphragm springs. As the clutch center plate wears, coil spring pressure reduces, diaphragm spring pressure remains constant. Okay. And now the references I have seen from this books. So these are the reference books. Go through this so you can understand the right concept of coil spring pressure plate. Okay. And at last, in the summary, we have seen pressure plates, types of pressure plates, coil spring pressure plates, definition, working principle, advantages and disadvantages. Okay. So it is a very short topic, but I given little bit detailed, so you can understand it very clearly. It is short topic, but I given some detail here. Okay. So till then, from pressure plates to disadvantages, we have seen in this video. Okay. At last, I want to thank you all to listening this video, so that you have I explained in the previous slide same way. It is a very short topic. It is a very small topic, so that you can understand it clearly. Okay, for that purpose, I've given it briefly. So it is a very short topic. That's why I'm going to finish it early. Okay, so it is automobile engineering. We have seen about coil spring pressure plate, my 8th lecture, and I will meet you on the next lecture with diaphragm spring pressure plate. Okay, till then, thank you.